Welcome to the Powerhouse, a house for worship, a house of prayer, a house with hope, love, respect, with the one and only Bishop Dr. Kofi Adonse Boateng. Welcome to the Divine Word.
Amen. Amen. Lift up your hand, everybody, and say, Lord, bless my life.
Lord, bless my life.
I want my time here to be blessed.
I want my time here to be blessed.
I need your hand.
I need your hand.
I need your favor.
I need your favor.
I want to see your glory.
I want to see your glory.
Manifest.
Manifest.
In my life.
In my life.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Lift up your hand, everybody, and close your eyes. Lift up your hands and close your eyes and be in the spirit. One of the things I realized Jesus Christ in his ministry he did, at the time he did, his disciples got confused for Jesus doing that. The Bible said he went and saw a fig tree, was expecting the tree to be fruitful. But when he approached the tree, he realized that there was nothing on the tree. So Jesus cursed the tree. The disciples said, that is an innocent tree. Why would you curse it? Jesus said, I expected it to be fruitful, but it is empty. This is what the devil expects you and I to be. That there will be no productivity in our lives. You will work and work and work and nothing fruitful will come out of your life.
Jesus.
Bible si onyankopon si on pese obonini be fraye ntem. Enya wo bato hia enemuguase. Awadie munsam. And the struggles we face. The tree was supposed to be fruitful, but there was no fruit on it. How long have you been in America? What fruit have you to show? How long have you been in the ministry? What fruit have you to show? How long have you been a Christian? What fruit have you to show?
How long?
How long have you been married? What fruit have you to show? How long have you been in business? What fruit have you to show?
How long?
The Bible says when they came back, the tree that was cursed, it died. If you are failing to produce, Jesus said you don't deserve to live. If you are failing to produce in America here, if you are failing to be productive in your life, in your marriage, in every sector of your life, something must happen.
Yes, Lord.
For that curse to be reversed.
Yes, Lord.
I said, if you are failing to produce out of any reason, your business, your ventures, and there seem to be nothing going on in your life, that curse must be reversed. You must see a change and a transformation in your life.
In the name of Jesus.
Lift up your right hand and close your eyes. There's a curse that must be broken out of your life. And I'll be very happy to be part of breaking that curse from your life.
Amen.
Close your eyes and be in the spirit. Anything that causes you not to be productive. Everybody be in the spirit and close your eyes, please. Please. As your eyes are closed, I want you to go deep into the realms of the spirit and begin to speak to that curse of unproductivity in your life. Don't shout. Go deep into the realms of the spirit. It is the expectations of the devil that you will fail. It is the expectations of the enemy that your work will end up zero. Eka utamfu nkwanka ubira ubire nyina no. Emfaso bia maso. Ume ubeshwa omwa ombenyini no munyina ye basa. All your children, you will take them to the daycare, to the school, to do everything, even the university in America, but they will grow up and become dependent on you. You have failed. Open your mouth, don't shout, and begin to pray. Speak to that curse. Speak to that curse. That curse of failure. You are trying, but you are not making impact. Peter said unto Jesus, Master, we have tried all night, done everything we know, done everything we can do, but we caught nothing. Master, we have done everything we know we could do from experience, strategize, done everything, but there is no productivity. Come on, speak, open your mouth, don't shout, and speak to that curse. Break that curse from your life. Speak to that curse over your daughter, over your son, over your business, over your marriage. Any infertility in any area of your life, speak to it and curse it. Break it. Look how long you have been a Christian. You have just jumped from every church to every church. What have you to show? Look how long you've been married. But there is no happiness in your house. Look how long you've been a professional. Been to the university, attained a master's degree. You are still struggling as if you just came to America. Come on, speak to that curse, somebody. Come on, speak to that curse. Speak to that curse. No, maybe I doubt so. My baby, I will be answering any
in the name of Jesus.
Come on, speak to it. How many men have been into your life to marry you? But nobody ever married you. Come on, I thought I'm watching you praying. Speak to that curse, please. I said, speak to that curse, please. Speak to that curse. Maybe this curse is over your family. Maybe this curse is over your children. Maybe this curse is over your life. Maybe this curse is over your marriage. Unproductivity. Unproductivity. Pray, don't stop. I did not ask you to stop. Pray, don't stop. Pray, don't stop. I can feel you traveling in the spirit. It looks like you are just running around this area. You are not seeing the gravity of the problem you are facing. But my sister, there is a curse that is causing an unproductivity in your life. My brother, there is a curse that is fighting you and causing you to be unproductive. I want you to be
angry. Begin to fight that curse and break that curse tonight in the name of Jesus. Can you start putting your hands together? Can you start putting your hands together? Come on, can you start getting angry? Can you start traveling? I want you to break that curse tonight. That curse of unproductivity.
Everybody lift up your right hand. The reason why I want you to take this 1 hour or so prayer is very serious. Last night when I was on my way from the office to the house, I told my wife that I saw a big sign in the cloud. It was a sign that was written, permanent failure. My heart broke when I saw the word permanent. It's not just failure, but a failure that is permanent. It means that permanently you will fail, you will fail, you will fail. So whatsoever you will do, but if you read the Bible in Psalm 1 verse 3, the Bible says for those who would read the Bible and not sit in the counsel of the ungodly, the Bible says, God said, I will cause you to be like a tree that is planted by rivers of what? Living.
Yes, hear me know.
But that is the expectation of God. That God will cause you to be like a tree that is planted in a watery area. All the time, with season and without season and in season, you should be fruitful.
Amen.
But the expectation of the devil is to cause you that you will permanently what? Fail.
Says.
That is why I'm angry. The whole night I could not sleep. The word just continued to ring in my ears. Permanent failure. Permanent failure. I could not just sleep to see that the devil is expecting you or me that permanently I will fail. Say, I refuse that.
I refuse that.
I can't hear you. Say, I refuse that.
I refuse that.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I will not fail.
I will not fail.
Temporarily. And not permanently. You see, the point is, temporarily you will not fail. And so if temporarily you will not fail, permanently you cannot fail. Say amen to that.
Amen. Say amen to that.
Say amen to that.
Amen. Say amen to that.
Say amen to that.
Amen.
There are some people in life, whatsoever they will put their hands on, something will just happen and there will be trouble in it. If they come and borrow your car, their car will go and get accident. If they borrow your phone that I want to make a call with your phone, the phone will drop from their hands, Jesus. And your phone will break. Anything their hand will touch, something will happen.
Jesus.
There will be trouble. Am I making sense to you?
Yes.
So I saw it written boldly in the sky. Permanent failure. You see, the point is, the devil himself is a failure. A failure cannot classify somebody a failure. Because when Jesus Christ died and he arose again, he conquered the devil. The devil failed.
Yes.
And Jesus won the battle.
Yes.
If you are here, declare for your life, you shall not fail. 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 Now lift up your right hand.
The reason why I ask you to lift your right hand is most of us, we use our right hand to do productivity. So when Jesus was leaving the earth, he told his disciples and the people who gathered that I am going to sit where? On the right side of the what? The Father. Not just anywhere, not on the left. I am going to take my place at the right hand side of the Father. So with your hand lifted, God said he will cause you to be like a tree that is planted by rivers of living waters.
Amen.
Then he declared, from this day, anything your hand will find to do shall prosper.
Amen. And I declare over your life, with your hand lifted, I prophesy in the name of Jesus, anything your hand will find to do, you shall prosper. Anything your hand will find to do, you shall prosper. Anything your hand will find to do, you shall prosper. Lift up your hand and say,
lift up your right hand, everybody. They want you to fail not just temporarily, but they want you to fail permanently.
Jesus.
Devil, who are you to make a declaration over my life? Remember, you are a child of God.
Amen.
Sanctified by the blood of Jesus. Blessed by an anointed, holy, blessed son of Jesus.
Amen.
And my sister, I declare in the name of Jesus, you cannot fail. You cannot fail. You will not 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 fail. Let me see your right hand up. This is why the Bible said the expectations of the righteous cannot be cut off.
Yes, sir. Amen.
The expectation. And the Bible says all our heart desires shall be made what? Perfect.
Amen.
All our heart desires shall be made perfect.
Amen.
So the Bible says all your heart desires will be made perfect and your expectations cannot be cut off.
Amen.
My sister, God has a plan for you.
Yes, Lord.
My brother, God has a plan for you.
Amen.
No matter what the devil will do,
Amen.
No matter what your enemies will do, you will not fail.
Amen.
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 You will not fail. 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 Let me know. Let me see your right hand. Let me see your right hand. It is important that as you are receiving this impartation from today, things you have tried in the past with your hand and failed,
Jesus,
I command in the name of Jesus, you are leaving this house to go and do the same thing again.
Amen.
But this time you shall not fail.
Amen.
But you shall prosper.
Amen.
You shall not fail.
Amen.
You shall prosper.
Amen.
You shall not fail.
Amen.
You shall prosper.
Amen.
You shall not fail.
Amen.
You shall prosper.
Amen.
You shall not fail.
Amen.
You shall prosper.
Amen.
You shall not fail.
Amen.
You shall prosper.
Amen.
You shall not fail.
Amen.
You shall prosper.
Amen.
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 Lift up your right hand. Lift up your right hand, everybody. And last night, in the middle of the night, when I was praying, they can send a demonic agent to somebody's business. The person comes and buys something with your business, and on the money they are buying from your business, they've cursed the money that if this money goes into your cashier's register, permanently your business will fail.
Jesus.
Lift up your right hand, somebody.
Shaka-haya.
Permanent failure. I refuse it in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
When they declare permanent failure upon you, everything you do, you will fail. Just common thing, you will fail. Anything that anybody else will do and be successful, when they put a curse of permanent failure on you, just common things, ordinary things, you will fail. But tonight, in the name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
That permanent failure curse placed upon you, I see the handwriting of Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
Canceling that curse from you. Breaking 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 that curse. 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 Breaking that curse.
Amen. Please lift up your right hand. If you read the Bible in Colossians 2:14, there is a scripture there that the devil has written a statement which is in opposition. If something is in opposition, opposition is something that presses you backwards. The Bible is saying that the devil has a handwriting of some statement that has been written. And you can say anything about anybody, but the moment you write it, the language and the perception is different. And the Bible is saying there's a handwriting of the devil on the wall, writing a statement and a comment which is in opposition to your progress. While you are struggling your way forward, maybe towards marriage, somebody is sitting somewhere with a handwriting inscribing negative and stupid folly stuff, trying to push you back.
Jeez.
That is why in the Bible, John 8, that poor woman the men brought about that she has committed adultery, and they persecuted and condemned the woman, and they were expecting Jesus Christ to put the woman down. Jesus Christ, the Bible said, knelt down. Every word they said about the woman, Jesus Christ canceled them one by one. Any opposition to your life, any opposition to your marriage, any opposition to your destiny, in the name of Jesus, we cancel. 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 In the name of Jesus, we
cancel.
Lift up your right hand. There is a writing in the sky,
Jesus,
over your life that you will fail permanently. This time I want you to fight against that permanent failure.
Name of Jesus.
This is like a stamp. This is like a label. There's a label that has been placed over you. You know, if you go to the store and you want to buy Michael Kors, there is a label that indicates that this is Michael Kors. And if you go to Louis Vuitton, you can tell another difference in the bags by seeing a Louis Vuitton bag, because there is a difference. The devil has stamped a label that is very cheap and low over you. But my sister, you are not that low.
Hey.
My brother, you are not that low.
Yeah.
My sister, you are not that low.
Yeah.
You are above.
Yeah.
You are above.
Yeah.
You are above.
Yeah.
You are a winner.
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 Yeah.
You are a champion.
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 Yeah.
You are a champion. 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 Lift up your hands. Now lift up your right hand again. The label they are trying to put on you is a wrong label. Your quality is too good for them to put a Walmart label on you.
Hear me, no.
But yo, I can utan fun kuanka. When you money am no unshere ni nechi, mama. Yeah, the Walmart label be,
Mama Monya Woma Lebulo. Who price in here about $78 billion? I don't know. I don't know. But you are a winner. 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 Let the banner sound.
Yes, service.
I want to see your right hand up.
The Bible says from this day forward, anything your hand will find to do,
yes, Lord,
it shall prosper.
In the name of Jesus.
Let me say this in key. What say? If any day you come,
sir,
a day be a wunsa, ebe somu sa obe yeno.
Yes, Lord.
And she has said, and woe, and see ye, 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 and see ye,
lift up your hands,
Iris. Say it.
Lift up your right hand, everybody. The label was permanent. What?
Failure.
I can. The label I saw in the sky was what?
Permanent failure.
And it was weird. Yesterday, after I have prayed with the people on the prayer line, that I saw this thing in the sky. Then a lot of people began to say on the prayer line, Mama, that an unknown number in the course of time has been sending this, but people, when they receive it, they just delete it. The devil has sent a text message which is unknown to your phone saying that permanent failure. You, a Christian, you see such a thing and you just delete. Did you rebuke it? Did you reject it? Jesus. Did you cancel it? Jesus. Did you nullify? Jesus. For any pronouncement the devil has placed, yes, over your,
yes,
life,
yes,
in the blood of Jesus, yes, tonight we cancel. You will not fail. 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 Lift up your hands.
I resist.
Remember in Genesis, the Bible says when the brothers of Joseph saw him coming from afar. Listen to the language. When the brothers of Joseph saw him, not close, they saw him coming from afar. It means that they had seen something unique and different about him. The Bible said when they saw him coming from afar, they said, here comes the dreamer. They didn't say, here comes our brother, our Joseph. The devil is not interested in my suit. The devil is not interested in the church. The devil is in something that God is about to do tomorrow.
Hey.
But they cannot stop you.
Yes,
the devil cannot stop you.
Hey,
the devil cannot stop you. The devil cannot stop you. The devil cannot stop you. They can't 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 stop you. Say amen. They said, here comes the dreamer. Let us kill him and see what comes of his dream. So you think because I'm standing here, that's why somebody's looking to kill me? They know tomorrow by this time that Kofi Adontin-Boateng was standing in Virginia.
Hey.
You will not see me here.
Hey.
I'll be flying a private jet.
Hey.
I'll be flying a private jet.
Hey.
I'll be owning my private jet.
Hey.
I will be driving in my private jet. Lift up your hands. But they made a mistake. They say, here comes the dreamer. Let's kill him and see what comes of his dream. But you know, If the dream is not of a man, you see, if the dream is of my father, you can kill my father, you have stopped it. If the dream is of my mother, you can kill my mother. If it is my own dream, you can stop it. But what if the dream is of the Lord?
Hey.
What if your dream is of the Lord?
Hey.
To kill him to stop the dream. So when they took him, then you know what? One of the things I have seen God done always, and I tell a lot of pastors, if you're dealing with God, be very careful. I can come against this man, insult him in the face. He's a father. I might be a bishop here. But you know what? I should show respect to him as a father. Maybe I'm too proud and arrogant. And I feel that I have money. I feel that people respect me. So I could come against this man and talk to him anyhow. You see, the moment I do that and I elevate myself against him, let me tell you, God might not say anything. But the moment I begin to lift up my hand, there is a spiritual covering that protects him. That is why your enemies will see that you are not just a man. You are not just a man, but you are a child of God. When they approach Joseph to kill him, God caused confusion. The plan was to make sure David, Joseph will fail permanently. See, Casa Mama, Johnny Life, man, in 80. The plan was to see Joseph's dream fail permanently. But let me tell you something. You might be in America struggling, but in the midst of your struggle, I saw the handwriting of God telling me that you are not lost. You are not lost. You will not fail. 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 Lift up your hands and say, when they tried to kill the young man, God caused confusion. One said, people said, let's kill him. Others said, let's wait a little. Your enemies thought that you were knocking their heads together, but it is a protection of God over you. No weapon that is fashioned against you. No weapon. 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 No
weapon. No as we honor you, we give you glory.